We always say we're not crop farmers that have sheep or sheep farmers that have crop. It's they're integrated together and one relies on the other. So my name's Scott Newby. I farm here at just east of Broomehill with my brother Wayne on family property that we've had for over 110 years. And we're running 1,500 Marino ewes and various terminal crossbreds and composites. We're shearing about 3,000 sheep and cropping about 80% of the farm, about 2,000 hectares of crop. For backlining ewes and drenching and what have you, we used to just run everything through the race. We'd draft things up manually and then run them around and through the race. Using handlers has changed the way we've done big jobs like weaning, where you're doing multiple jobs at once, because it cuts down on all the double handling and the going back through the race for a second or third time. We're using this handler for drenching, we'll be doing vaccinating, we're doing our back lining. Hopefully we may do some weaning in it. This handler's a Peak Hill immobiliser. It's pneumatic, electric pneumatic. So we run the sheep in, there's a no stop, no return segment here. So seeing eye trips the unit with pneumatic actuators that clamps the sheep from both sides. So you adjust the pressure for the clamp to have it comfortable for the sheep, and you've got a manual clamp and manual releases to let him go again. If you're a one-man show, you can walk back and push sheep up and you know it's going to grab it, whereas a mechanical one, if you're on your own, you can't leave your post. The benefits we're looking at getting out of something like this for the business is just to not have to rely on that second labour unit, and of course in the end of the day you'd like some efficiency gains and actually put a few dollars back in your pocket.
I'm Peter O. I'm an agricultural consultant and I've been working in the field for over 20 years. I was asked by the Department of Agriculture and Food to look at the newbie's potential investment in a sheep handler. The system that they're looking at costs around $17,000 to buy. Across 10 years, the system will save them around $10,000, which means that the net present value is actually minus $6,000. The benefit cost ratio is 0.6, meaning they spend a dollar, they get 60 cents back. The newbies have 1,500 ewes in their flock, and at 2,500 ewes, then the newbies would break even. And if they increase the ewe flock up to 4,000, then the newbies would return $1.50 for each dollar they invest. So it's clearly dependent on the number of ewes that you have within your system.
Things that are difficult to cost out is the fact that you're not fighting sheep in the race all day, and you can stick it out for a bit longer. We've definitely noticed the difference between day-to-day productivity of staff, myself primarily, especially if you're not wrestling with heavy ewes in a race trying to give needles. Or we'd be quite happy to increase our sheep numbers going forward. It's all just based on the economics for us. We just try and use all the tools available to us to get the best result out of our sheep flock.
The Department of Agriculture and Food WA, through its Sheep Industry Business Innovation Project, made possible by royalties for regions, is supporting and sharing new technologies in the sheep industry. This is improving labour efficiency in the sector and making it easier all round to run sheep.